Hello, all guys. Can you hear me quickly? Just let me know. Evening, everyone. Am I audible? Yeah, just hit like so that we'll probably start in just a couple of minutes. Okay. We'll wait till everybody joins. Am I audible, everyone? I guess. Hello, hello. So this is the day two time series. We'll focus on many things today. So today we are probably going to see what is simple moving average. What is cumulative moving average? What is cumulative moving average? The third point that we are probably going to focus on is simple moving average, cumulative moving average. Then we are also going to see exponential moving EWMA, moving weighted average, EW, exponential weight moving average. Okay, fourth one, if this is done, then exponential. These all things we'll see with the help of Excel sheet plus coding. And same thing will basically be for both of them. And then we are also going to see moving average, we'll try to see the formula. And probably we'll also probably see PACF, ACF, ACF autocorrelation plot. And fifth, we are also going to see autoregressive model. Okay. And here we'll also see some plots like PACF, partial autocorrelation. Okay. So exponential weighted moving average, fine. Okay, so all these things we are probably going to see today, because I guess in 1.5 hour we'll be able to cover this. In tomorrow's session, we will try to solve ARIMA, because here only this is my MA, this is my AR model. So if I combine both these things, it becomes ARMA model. Okay, then tomorrow's session, we will try to see ARIMA plus different models like Arimax, Sarimax. So all these models we'll try to see tomorrow. Okay, but here today we are mostly going to understand most of the important things. I'll try to show you with the help of coding also, and with the help of Excel sheet also, how you can probably be able to do it. Clear? Okay. Shiva Kumar says, can you suggest some books for learning time series? There are many books as such, guys. I definitely I don't know like which to follow. All are written in a proper way. Okay. So hit like and just let me know whether you are ready so that we can start. Is my volume low? Let me check it out. No, my volume is not low. Fine. Is it? Hello. 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 Now, guys, I hope my volume is fine, right? Hello. So guys, I hope it is audible. I'll just try to reduce a little bit. Fine. I think it is perfect. Okay. So let's go ahead. Let's try to first of all see simple moving average. Now, as usual, let's start with. In the simple moving average, the first thing is that again, we'll take a specific data set and probably do it. We can take the Tesla data set, what we have actually done yesterday. So I hope everybody remembers which all libraries we have specifically used. But did you do the assignment that I'd actually given yesterday? Just let me know, okay, whether you have done the assignment or not. So till then, I'll just import all the libraries. I'll say import pandas data reader as PDR and then import pandas as PD. And from date time, I'm going to import date time. Okay, so these three libraries I'll definitely require. So I'm just going to read my Tesla data set. And I'm basically going to do pdr.getDataYahoo. I can basically take it from DataYahoo. That basically means I'm taking the data from Yahoo Finance, and this will probably give me the last 5 years data set. So here you can basically go and see DF. So sorry, DF underscore Tesla. And here you'll be able to see all my data is there from 2022. Yesterday we were working only till 24, but today we can see till 25th date. We have all the data, and today is 26th. Probably in US it is 25th. So here you can see all the data that is required. Okay. Now let's go ahead and let's try to cover up all the topics that I have written over there quickly, so that you'll get an idea about what all things we can basically do. And before that, you've done the assignment properly. Great. Okay. So perfect. So let me make some cells. Now, first thing first, we really need to discuss about something called as simple moving average. Okay. Now, what exactly is simple moving average? I'll just try to show it to you with the help of notebook where I'll specifically write. Let's consider that. Okay. Let's consider that over here. Suppose I have my data sets, right? So I have my open column of my data set. Let's say that I have data's values like 12, 13, 15, 17, 11, 12, 5. Okay. So yesterday we had used, something called as rolling function. And many people were actually getting confused. What exactly is this rolling function? Okay. Now here I'm actually going to say what exactly is this rolling function. Now, if I talk about simple moving average, in simple moving average, let's say that my rolling window, my window size is 10. Okay. Now, this basically means that what I'm actually going to do, suppose my window size is 5. Let me just say that, okay, it is 5. Window size is 5. Now, with respect to window size as 5, and with the help of simple moving average, what we are actually going to do is that we are going to take this initial 5 data. So this is my 1 data, 2 data, 3 data, 4 data, and 5 data. For this entire 5 data, and for this particular field, okay, the simple moving average will be nothing but this plus this plus this plus this plus this divided by 5. So if I probably say it will be 12 plus 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 11 plus 12. This entirely will be divided by 5. Now, just tell me why. What is the answer with respect to this? Because here I've set the window size as 5. That is the reason whenever we use rolling function here, all the values will be coming as NaN. Okay. NaN, NaN, NaN. So if I probably try to see this, okay, and try to find out the output, you will be able to see if I open my calculator. okay? And if I probably open and calculate, it is 12 plus 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 11 plus 2, okay? And this will be entirely divided by 5. So here you can see 16. So here, obviously, my answer will be 16, okay? Now, what will happen next? In order to calculate the simple moving average for this line, then what we are going to do, we are just going to move. Since my window size is 5, the next window size, we are going to just move by one step. That is this all elements. So it will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, right? So similarly, what I will do in order to calculate over here, I will just write it as 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 11 plus 12 divided by 5. Now, if I probably try to calculate it here again, how much it will be? So here you can basically see that if I probably try to write it down, 13 plus 15 plus 17 plus 11 plus 12 divided by 5. So here you can see it is 13.6, right? 13.6. So again, I'm actually dividing by 5 with respect to this, okay? No, it will be divided by 5. See, I'm moving one step down, right? My window size is actually 5. So when I'm actually trying to calculate the simple moving average, considering the 5 elements for this row, so it will get shifted one position by Dan. And okay, and it will probably take this all things and it will basically calculate it. Okay, so 1, 2, 3. Okay, just a second. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so if I probably, so this element will belong to this row, this element will belong to this row. Okay, so in this way, you will be able to find it. This is the mapping that will be done. This will be the mapping that will be done. Because before this 11, you don't have any simple moving average over here. Okay, so just this mapping, consider this mapping. Okay, and probably you'll be able to see this over here, that I'm basically taking this first 5 sum and probably pointing it over here instead of writing the row down. Okay, so again, if you want to consider, this entire thing is just getting shifted by one thing. Okay, so this is perfect and this will get dropped. Okay, this will basically get dropped and here we are just going to go towards one position. And this is what simple moving average is all about. Okay, and similarly, you will just go and keep on doing it. Then the next element, again, you'll move one position down and the next position will be this 5 elements, which you will probably calculate. And just tell me how much it will be coming. 15 plus 17 plus 11 plus 12 plus 5. Okay, divided by 5. So what will be the output over here? Okay, what will be the output over here? Just tell me. So if I probably try to calculate with respect to the calculator, so it will be 15 plus 17 plus 11 plus 12 plus 5. Okay, and here if I probably divide by 5, it will be 12. Okay, so finally I'm actually going to get 12 as my output. So like this, we can calculate the entire simple moving average. It's very simple. Based on the window size, we are just trying to calculate it and we are trying to plot that specific diagram. So suppose if my graph is something like this, suppose my graph looks something like this, where it is having a lot of zigzag and probably like this. If you are trying to apply simple moving average, you will be able to see that we will be getting a smooth graph, which will actually help you to, okay, Paninda Pratap, I'm going to hide you because I think you should not join the session, okay? Okay, so this is clear, everybody. Can I get quickly? Yes. I hope everybody is clear. So in short, you are actually smoothening the curve. In short, you are actually smoothening the curve. Yeah. Yes. Simple moving average. Yes, absolutely right. Yesterday, whatever code we had actually written, first equation, please look at it. Which first equation? I have not written any equation over here. Okay. Sorry. So this will be plus 11. Now this is fine, right? No. Does it called as moving average? No, it is called as simple moving average. Okay, so this entire thing is actually called as simple moving average. Okay, moving average is completely different. We'll talk about it. Okay. So here you have five elements and then here you have next five elements. So probably what you're doing over here, I just added one more element, but understand the concept, guys. Calculation is not that important. Okay. Calculation is not that important because with the help of code, you'll obviously get perfect solution. Okay. Fine. 12 was not there. I can say that, okay, change the window size from 5 to 6, then probably you'll add 12. You'll try add the next element. Okay. But it's okay. Try to understand what I'm trying to teach you. Don't focus more on the calculation. This is a live session. So it's okay. We can go ahead with it. Okay. So I hope everybody has got that. Okay. And you are able to clear this. Now let's go ahead and do it with the help of coding. Okay. So what I'm actually going to say over here is that I will just try to, okay, why simple moving average? It is basically just to do some kind of smoothening of the graph. Okay. Whatever graphs you have. Now, suppose if I say df of open dot plot, if I try to just create this plot, df underscore Tesla. And here you can see that obviously this plot looks quite, a lot of zigzag movements are there. Probably I want to put with some kind of figure size. Let's say I'm putting figure size as 15.6. Now here you can see this entire graph. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is that I'm just going to create a simple moving average of this specific graph. You can also provide your X limit, Y limit. That is fine. But in order to create a simple moving average, what I'm actually going to do, I'm just going to create a column. Say that for open, this will be my 10 windows, 10 days rolling. Okay. So this will be my 10 days rolling. And here I'm going to just say that df underscore Tesla. So here also I'm going to write df underscore Tesla. And here I'm going to just take my open column dot rolling, and here I'm just going to specify. See, in rolling you have something called as window, like whether you want 10 windows, whether you want 20 windows, what should be your window size. And in window there is also one specific thing. Okay, if I probably consider this, okay, what we can also do is that I'll just try to write it down in front of you. Okay, suppose this is my open column. Okay, suppose this is my open column. If I probably say, okay, fine, my window size is 10, okay? So, which is obviously given over here. You can see the first parameter in the rolling. So, here I can say that window size is some specific size. And there is also one more parameter which is called as periods, okay? Now, with respect to this particular period, if I say my minimum periods is equal to 1, okay? So, what will happen is that, suppose I say I have some values like this, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 11. Okay. If I say my window size is, let's say 5. Okay. Let's say my window size is 5. So, and with respect to this minimum periods, now see, if I'm trying to calculate the simple moving average, okay, obviously you will be able to see that for calculating the first 5, obviously to calculate the first 5, I will obviously get the answer over here. Okay. But these all values will never be NaN. Okay. Because we are just going to keep one value as NaN over here and remaining all values will be the same values. Okay. That is what this specific thing says. If I say minimum period is equal to 5, then it will probably put all the starting values as 5 NaN. Okay. So this is what it is basically doing it with the help of minimum periods. Okay. Since I don't want to put NaN, because if I don't put NaN, if I just say that my minimum periods is 10, that basically means my starting 10 value will all become NaN. Okay. I don't want to do that because I want to make sure that the line starts from the starting, because if there is NaN, then the line will not probably start from at that point of time. Okay. So that is what I'm actually planning to do. Okay. So let's go ahead and let's try to do this. So here I'm actually going to say my window size will be probably 10, because I'm making 10 And then I will also say my minimum periods is equal to, let's say, 1. Okay. So if I try to execute this, and after this, I have to use an aggregated function to find out the mean value. Okay. Because we are doing a simple moving average. Okay. So here you can basically see dot rolling of window 10 and minimum periods is equal to 1 dot mean. So if I execute this, you will be able to see my df of open 10, df underscore Tesla, open, or let me just directly plot it. Okay. So here I'm actually going to plot two important features. One is open and the other one is open 10 days rolling. I'm just going to copy this and paste it over here. It's not about deciding the window size, guys. Still, we are in the analyzing state, okay? You don't have to decide anything over here. So if I try to plot it, now here you will be able to see. Let me make my figure size a little bit bigger. And here I'm actually going to specify 15,6. So my figure looks quite good. Now, with respect to the orange line, I know you are not able to see the line properly. So I'm actually going to keep some X limit. So let's say my X limit is equal to, and again, I can give this in the form of list. It will probably start from, let's say, from 2020, 0101, for till 2021, 0101. So I'm just focusing on probably the first year data from 2020 to 2021. Okay. So if I execute it, now here you can see, based on this graph, we are able to get this simple moving average. Now, why specifically this is getting used? Why people are using this? If I probably open this image in new tab, if I zoom in, right? Why specifically people are actually using this? I'll also show you that. So let me open my Epic Pen. Okay. Now, in financing, right? In financing, why do they probably use? Specifically in stock markets, right? In stock markets, right? You'll be able to see that at one point of time, when this specific line crosses, okay, or probably when the line actually touches and when this line is below this, you know, so this can be a buy situation for the people. This can be actually sell situation for the people, you know. Over here also, you can see that after the line is basically touching, it is then going up. So this can also be an indication to probably say that, okay, this is a buy time for you. Over here, you can specifically see that when this line crosses, it is probably the time to actually sell your stocks, okay? So this smoothening method, right, with the help of simple moving average for the short term is also extensively used in stock markets, okay? Now, what you should basically do, you should just not depend on this 10 rolling window. Instead, you can create any number of rolling windows, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, and try to probably create that specific graph and try to see that how this specific thing is actually working. Okay. So I hope you are actually able to understand what I'm actually trying to say. So similarly, what I will do is that I will create a lot of different rollings. So here I'm going to basically specify this. This time my rolling will be 30. Let's say I'm going to do it for 30. So here you'll be able to see 30. And similarly, what I can do is that I can also make it for 50. Let's make it for 50. And different rolling part I can actually make. And then I can also make sure that I plot all those things and then try to compare. Okay. Try to compare. So I'm going to basically plot it for open 10 days, open 20 days. Okay. Open 20 days, open 30 days like this. Open 20 days, right? And similarly, I can do it for open 30 days. Open 30 days, right? I can actually do all this thing for different days and just try to plot it. Now see, I'm getting an error. 20 days rolling is not there. Okay, 20 is not there. 30 and 50 are there, fine. 30 and 50. So if I execute, sorry, not 40, it's 50. Okay. Now here you can see that how this graph looks like. The open 10 days, actually, when it is providing the smoothening, you can see there is a difference, right? With respect to the green color, open 30 days rolling and 50 days rolling, you can also see something. Over here, let me open the image in new tab so that we can zoom in. The green, I don't see the green one. Why? Specific reason for the green one, I don't see it. Open 10 days, 30 days, 50 days dot plot. 30 days. Okay, both are same. So here I'm going to just make it for 50. I did not change it to 50. So now you will be able to see that. I'm able to see this in the image tag in an amazing way, right? So I hope you are able to understand this. Till here, everybody is clear? No, red was not overlapping the green because I had, for 50 also, I had kept the rolling sizes 30. Okay? Everybody clear? Yeah? So this is how powerful a simple moving average is. And you can definitely do anything with respect to the smoothing. But see, initially my graph was a lot of zigzag. Now I'm actually smoothing it and I'm doing it. Now, there is some disadvantages with respect to the simple moving average. Okay, a lot of disadvantage. Now, what is the major disadvantage with respect to simple moving average? See, I'm just going to talk about disadvantage of simple moving average. Disadvantage of simple moving average. Now see, one thing is that whenever you are probably trying to add up or trying to find a simple moving average, you're giving an importance to all the data. You're giving importance. And what kind of importance? Similar importance. Similar importance to all the data. Because when you are calculating the average, you're just doing x1 plus x2 plus x3 plus like this till xn divided by n. You're always doing in this way itself, right? It is always, you're actually trying to always provide this specific formula to all the data points based on the window size, okay? Where n probably may be your window size, right? You're doing this, right? So what is the problem with respect to this? Because see, in time series data, our main focus should be given to the recent data a lot, right? And based on that, we should definitely do the predictions, okay? Please don't this to Rabindra. Guys, this need not be used in stock markets and all. Again, understand I'm teaching this for a purpose so that you can clear the interviews and do something, okay? Please don't do that, okay? Don't go and invest your money. Please note, you will not become a millionaire by stock. You will not become a millionaire. I have greatly written from all these things. This is just for educational purpose. Educational purpose. Okay? I know everybody wants money without doing any kind of hard work. Okay? So, with respect to this, you know, what I really want is that I want to give more importance, or I can definitely say more weight to the recent data. Okay? More weight to the recent data, and that weight is basically provided by some parameters which we are probably going to see in something called as EWMA, okay? Exponential weighted mean average, okay? Sorry, moving average. Exponential weighted moving average. We are going to see over there. But before that, let's go and focus on something called as cumulative moving average, because we really need to cover all these things. And this will actually help us to become a perfect thing in when we are discussing ARIMA model. So we require all these things, guys. So let's go and discuss about the cumulative moving average. The cumulative moving average is pretty much simple. So suppose if this is my open column, okay? Suppose this is my open column and I have probably values like 12, 13, 11, 15, 16, 10, like this, right? In cumulative moving average, that is CMA, what we are specifically going to do, okay? What we are actually going to do, suppose if I want to find out till here, what is the cumulative moving average? So what I will do, I'll just try to calculate the average of this, okay? So both of this average, what is 12 plus 13 divided by 2? What it is? So it is somewhere around 12.5, right? Then with respect to this specific data, what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to basically find out the average of this three, Okay, this 3. So it will be 12 plus 13 plus 11 divided by 3. So what it will be? So if I try to calculate with the help of calculator, so here you will be able to see 12 plus 13 plus 11 divided by 3. So here I'm actually going to get 12, right? So this is specifically 12, right? Similarly, the next moving average, that is cumulative moving average, what I'm actually going to do? This all 4 sum and average I have to actually do. So here you will be able to see 12 plus 13 plus 11 plus 15 divided by 4. So here you'll be able to again go and calculate it with the help of calculator. So it'll be multiplied by 3 plus 15 divided by 4. Similarly, you're going to do this. So here you are actually going to get 12.75. Okay. So in this way, you will definitely be able to get the cumulative moving average. Okay. So here what you're doing, as you're going down, you are actually calculating the cumulative mean of all the values that are present in the previous date timestamps. Okay. So in order to do it practically, what I'm actually going to do is that I'm going to basically just write a code in a simple way. And over here, you'll be able to see that it's very, very simple. You can just directly use expanding. So expanding is a function which can actually help you to find it out. So expanding, okay. So if I write df of open, df underscore Tesla of open. Let me just write it down over here. So if I write df of open, okay, dot, there is a function which is called as expand. Expanding, okay. So if I press shift tab, here you'll be able to see minimum period by default is 1. It says that the definition is not given. Provide expanding transformation, it is basically saying, but definitely you'll be able to find out what exactly is this, okay. So if I probably try to do just dot mean on top of it and probably say dot plot in some figure size with 10,5, let's say, then you will be able to see that I'm actually getting a plot which looks like this. Okay. So this, as we go ahead, is this the moving cumulative moving average of the open stock with respect to different years, which you are actually able to see over here. Okay. Okay. So here it is. And if you probably try to find out the dot head, you will be able to see that. Okay. Okay. Everybody clear with this? So this was with respect to cumulative moving average. Clear? So this is my entire things with respect to rolling. This is my cumulative moving average. This is my simple mean average. Okay. This is just to give you an idea like how the summation is basically happening. Okay. Here I've basically used mean. The average is getting calculated, and here you can definitely see that the average is increasing. That basically means the stock price is also increasing. Yeah, it'll calculate from the stock first index. Okay, everybody clear? Everybody clear? Shall I continue? Okay. Now let's go to the next step. As I said that with respect to the simple moving average, there will definitely be a lot of lags, right? We need to try to find out an amazing way. As an example, exponential weighted moving average. Okay. Exponential weighted moving average. So this is what we need to do. Till then, just write down the code, everybody. Exponential weighted moving average. Now, in exponential weighted moving average, as I said that, our focus should be more on the current upcoming data or just on the recent data that we are actually getting so that we can do the projection properly. Okay. So for that, we use something called as exponential weighted moving average. Let me just show you one formula, one amazing formula with the help of a CSV file. Okay. Now, everybody, let's just focus on this CSV file. Everybody is able to see the CSV file. I'll also give the CSV file probably in my GitHub so that you will be able to see this. Okay. Everybody is able to see this. Just let me know. Okay. Yes. Yes, everyone. Just give me a yes, quick yes. Okay. Perfect. So people are saying yes. Perfect. Now, what is happening over here? Let's see. With respect to simple moving average, so this is my closed columns. Okay. So this is my closed column. Let's consider that this is my closed column of my stock data. And how did I create this stock data? With the help of the same thing. What I did, I just took that data set. I just did .2_CSV and converted it. Now, with respect to simple moving average, let's say that my window size is 10 initially. Okay. So this is my window size or whatever window size I've taken over here. What I'm actually going to see the formula that I have done. Average of E2:E10. Okay. Everybody is able to see the formula. Average of E2:E10. That basically means this entire average will probably give me the values of this specific simple moving average. Right. So here I will be able to see that I'm getting the simple moving average over here. Similarly, all the formulas E3:E11 will basically give me this. E4:E12. By applying an average formula will basically give me this, and probably you'll be able to see 49.81. I'm actually able to get the average of E5:E30, right? So this is what we have done with the help of simple moving average. Now, second, cumulative moving average. Now see, with respect to cumulative moving average, what I have actually done, suppose if I really want to find out the cumulative moving average, then initially, whatever for this specific row, if I want to calculate, I have to basically do the summation of both of this, right? Once I do the summation and average of both of this, then I'll be able to see this. So here you can see E2:E3, I'm actually doing the average and I'm actually getting it. Okay. So formula is not visible. Don't worry. Formula is simply a simple average function in Excel sheet. I cannot expand that. Okay. Simple average function. So here, if you want to see, here you can see average E2:E3. Okay. That basically means this two, E2:E3. Similarly, if I go and probably open this, average E2:E4. So these all three data, I'm actually going to do the average and I'm able to go to find it out. Okay. And similarly, if you probably go and open this, it is E2:E5, right? Average of this. And similarly, if I go and see E2:E6. So this is nothing but cumulative moving average. Clear, everybody? Similarly, over here for the simple average, you can see E2:E10. E3:E11 and E4:E12. So this is very, very simple, very, very easy. Do you want me to show like how the calculation is basically done again? Everybody is interested in Excel. So let me just show you. If you want to calculate the SMA, let's say my window size is 10. So for this 10, my previous data will not be there. Okay. And here I'm actually going to just write average, and here I'm basically going to specify what should be my first value from here till here, right? It should be colon. So this is just like E2:E10. So once I calculate this, so this will basically be my average, right? Then in order to calculate this, again, I will basically write average. And here I will specify what next one data till this. So E3:11. If I execute, I'm actually being able to see this values. Okay. And now what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to select both of this and continue doing whatever I want to do for all the other columns. And here you'll be able to see all the values will automatically get done. Okay. So you should know Excel. Okay. And then you can insert any kind of charts that you want. Probably create it like this. See over here, here is one chart, here is one chart. Suppose I want to create this chart, you can also create this. Right? So, please, as a data scientist, you should also know how to use an Excel sheet. It is always better. Okay? Your work will become very, very easy. Now, quickly do it for CMA, guys, if you can. CMA is very simple again. In order to do it, just create a new cell. Okay? Suppose this, I say this is my CMA. Okay? And for CMA, what I have to do? Cumulative sum, right? So, here I will basically write is equal to average. And here I'm going to specify for, let's say, average for open. I want to do it. So I'll select this and this. Done. 49.23. Okay. But then next one also again, I can do like this only. Average. So here I'm actually going to take this to this. Right. And then you can probably do it for all the rows. Average open, this is basically for cumulative open, right? Previous one was for close. Okay. Now, I can also go ahead and probably insert any kind of diagrams that I want. Okay, so this is how it looks like. Very simple. Now let's go ahead and discuss about the EWMA, exponential weighted moving average. Now the formula is quite simple, guys. Okay. CMA formula. Average formula only is the CMA formula. Okay. Okay. So everybody ready for the next one? Where I'm specifically discussing about this specific formula, EWMA, exponential weight moving average. So in exponential weight moving average, as I said that we really need to provide weights to the recent data. Okay. We really need to provide weights to the recent data. So here, one example I'm actually giving of the formula. What happens with respect to exponential weight moving average? The exponential weight moving average formula is something like this. Whichever column you want, you can take over here like close open. Minus previous exponential weight average multiplied by a multiplier. What is this multiplier? I'll talk about it. Okay. Plus again previous EMA. That is the exponential weighted average. Now, what exactly is this previous EMA? Suppose I'm just going to create a cell. Okay. Let's say this is my EMWA. And suppose here also I want to keep my rolling window as 10. Let's say my rolling window is 10. Okay. Let me do one thing. Let me hide all these columns because I don't require it. So I'm just going to select volume, this, and this. Let me hide it out. So this is hidden. Okay. So this is hidden. Now let's focus on this. Okay. Everybody see this. If I say that I don't have data for probably my rolling window is basically 10. That basically means for the first 10 records. If I probably see this is from 2 to 11. Okay. So for the first 10 records, I definitely will not have any data. Okay. And if I want to calculate the EWMA for this data, I obviously have to be dependent on the previous EMA, right? Previous EMA. But I don't have previous EMA, right? Sorry, EWMA. Should be EWMA. Okay, just a second. Exponential moving average, exponential weighted moving average. Let me just verify the formula once, guys, because this formula is little bit weighted moving average formula, but an amazing one. I'm just checking out the formula, guys, whether it is absolutely fine or not. 1 minus A. Okay. So this formula will change to something like this. Just a second. 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. No, no. This is not the formula for this. Just a second, guys. Just give me a second. This formula is basically for exponential moving average. Okay. Weighted one, I'll discuss it. Okay. So this formula is basically for exponential moving average. Okay. So this is just a change for it. I'll discuss about exponential weighted moving average also. So don't worry. Okay. So. Okay. Perfect. Now, everybody, see over here. So here also, I'm going to write it down as EMA. Fine. Now see, let's discuss with respect to this exponential moving average. Now, exponential moving average basically says that I have to really focus on the recent data by providing some values or by multiplying it from some values. And based on that, okay, we will try to see what are the values we will be getting. Okay. So here you can see that my formula is close minus previous EMA multiplied by multiplier plus previous EMA. That is the exponential moving average. Now, obviously, when I say my 10 is the rolling window over here. Now, for the first one, we cannot calculate EMA because this is the formula of EMA. And for that, we require previous EMA. And we don't have the previous EMA. Okay. Now, in order to get the previous EMA, what we should do is that we should start with the simple moving average initially. So if I probably talk about over here, for the first 10 records, I will just try to calculate the simple moving average. So I'll say average. And here specifically, I will write over here as this value. Let's say I'm doing it for close till this value. So this value will basically give me my average. Okay. Now here I'm actually getting the first simple average, simple moving average, because obviously I cannot calculate the exponential moving average because this is the formula for doing that. Now, the next thing what I'm actually going to do is that I'm just going to apply this specific formula. Now, in order to apply, what I will do, I'll just write equal to, and this will basically be my brackets, close minus. What is close value over here? Close value is this one. Minus, what is the previous EMA? Now, I have my previous EMA, right? Multiplier is also there. What exactly is this multiplier? I'm also going to talk about it. What exactly is this multiplier? Multiplier is given by a formula, very simple, and it is based on the rolling size. Right now, I have calculated the multiplier over here. Okay. Now, what exactly is this multiplier? By default, over here, I have calculated it as 0.181818. I guess I'm right. 181818. Okay. I'll tell you what is the formula of this multiplier and how you are actually getting it. Then I will just say plus and my previous EMA. Let me show you. My previous EMA will basically be this specific value again. And I'm just going to close this bracket and press enter. So here you can see that I'm actually able to find out the exponential moving average over here. Now, what is the formula of the multiplier? Multiplier is nothing but, the formula is very simple. It is nothing but 2 divided by 10 plus 1. What is this 10? 10 is nothing but whatever is my EMA rolling window size. I'm actually going to get it as 10 and this will be plus 1. Okay. So by this particular formula, we calculate the multiplier. Here we are not assigning weights yet. Okay. Here we are just focusing on using exponential effect in order to do the smoothening part. Now, similarly, I will go and calculate the next part over here. And in the next part, what I'm actually going to do, just a second. Okay, this have actually gone. I don't know why where it went, but here I'm just going to write 2 divided by 10 plus 1. So this is the formula of it. Okay. Now, the next thing that I'm actually going to do, calculate it for this particular cell again. Again, close minus. Here you can go ahead and calculate it. So here I'm just going to write What is the close? Close value is this. Okay. I'll just say equal to, and here I'm just going to basically say close minus previous EMA, and this I'm just going to multiply by the multiplier. Multiplier is nothing but the same constant value, that is 0.818. Okay, 0.81818. And then I'm basically going to say plus previous EMA. Okay, so previous EMA is this value, and I'm just going to compute it. So similarly, what I'm actually going to do, remaining all the computation will be done like this, and I will be able to see my values like this. Okay, and this way also we will be able to see this with respect to all the values that we have calculated. Still, we are focusing on exponential moving average. Okay, but when we try to calculate exponential weight moving average, the formula will change a little bit. Now, how does my formula change with respect to exponential weight moving average? So here is what I'm actually going to do with respect to exponential weight moving average. The formula is very much simple. If I really want to calculate EWMA with respect to T, then I can write A multiplied by X of T with some specific timestamp plus 1 minus A with respect to the previous timestamp that I'm actually trying to calculate the EMWA T minus 1. Okay, so here what I'm actually going to do is that this is specifically my weight that I'm giving, or I'm giving the priority to my first data instead of the previous one, right? And this is specifically done to prevent any kind of lags. Okay, to prevent any kind of lags. Now you should understand that, fine Krish, this is very good. I know like many people will hate equations and all, but we should have this kind of ideas how to basically do it. Okay, now let me just show you exponential moving average. How do you write a code? Okay, so first of all, I will just try to minimize this, and let me remove this with respect to weighted moving average, and let me just write the code with exponential moving average. It is very, very simple. Here I'm just going to copy the entire code and paste it over here. See this. With respect to what I'm actually doing with respect to exponential moving average, I'm written df_tesla.open. There is a function which is called as EWM. And if I probably press shift tab, you will be able to see that here you will be able to see provide exponentially weighted functions. Here you specify one alpha parameter. This alpha is just like your hyperparameter, which is just indicating the smoothening factor. Okay. And then you basically just try to calculate the mean. So if I execute this and if I plot it, with the help of the same code, you will be able to see the smoothening will be pretty much better without any lags. Okay. So here I'm just going to remove all these things. Okay. I'm going to just make it 2-, and here I'm just going to make AMA_0.1. Now, if I execute this, here you'll be able to see that now without any lag, I'm able to see the entire exponential moving average. Now, what is the advantage? Understand, you're removing lags and you are also trying to find out the exponential moving average, which was pretty much better than the simple moving average. Now, with respect to that, you'll be able to see this kind of data. And here you can see all the plotted data that is basically happening. The smoothening factor, if you want to probably make it more smoothen, you can play with different parameters. Let's say that I'm just going to copy the same thing. And now I'm just going to say my smoothing factor will be 0.3. And here I'm just going to set my alpha value as 0.3. And if I probably execute it, you will be able to see that I'm just trying to plot it over here with the help of EMA. EMA_0.3. And here if I execute it, here you'll be able to see the other smoothening one, which is with the help of green color, and it looks better than the orange one, right? It is more towards that specific data point. So definitely you have to try with multiple data points to get it in a better way. If you want to see this image in a new tab, here it is how it looks like, right? The green line that you are probably able to see. So alpha is basically a smoothing factor, right? Everybody clear with this? Let me see whether there is also an inbuilt parameter with respect to dot e. EWMA is not there. So if I write pandas e exponential weighted moving average. So if I probably be able to see this, here it is. You can see pandas.EWMA is also there. Okay. EWMA is also there. Let's see. Guys, over here, always understand there is no such optimal value. You have to definitely try with multiple values. So if I probably see there is something like EWMA. Is there any value like this? Is there any functions like this? I'll just copy and paste it over here. I think it'll get an error. The EWMA is not there or what? Pandas.EWMA. Let's see some examples. EWMA. Examples. I'll just search for some examples over here. Let's see some solutions we'll be able to see over here. EWM is only there. Exponential plot four soils exponential weighted moving average. And they have just calculated EWM. Okay. With the help of span, we can actually do that. So suppose if I say EWM and here all the parameters will be almost same. Okay. Alpha. And here I'm just going to say span is equal to 5, let's say. And if I try to execute, this will basically be with respect to 5 days. So here you will be able to see some example, comma, span, half-life and alpha are mutual exclusive. Okay. Let me remove this. Let me execute it. So if I probably just plot this everything. Comma EMA underscore 5 days. So here you'll be able to see dot plot. Okay, two brackets I have to use. So it looks better, I guess, in this side. I'm just going to use fix size is equal to 15.5. Does this look good, guys? Let me plot one more thing. And here also there is no lag. Here also there is no lag. And let me use some smoothening factor also like this. So here you can see with respect to green line also, EMA 5 days and EMA 0.1 with smoothening factor, you can basically use this. In general, wow, it's got a span. Okay, if I write pd.ewma is also not there. I don't know why in the documentation they have given this. How to call this then? Pandas EWMA. Okay, fine. So I hope from this article, you can definitely see create a new column to hold 4-day exponential weighted moving average. We can use pandas.dataframe.evma function to calculate the exponential weighted moving average for a certain number of periods. So here is given some example. Fine. But I hope you are actually got this idea. If you don't understand what exactly is span, just press shift tab. Here you'll be able to see span. Span says specify decay in terms of span. alpha is equal to 2 by span plus 1. Same thing, the multiplier effect. The same thing here you are saying, right? That basically means I'm giving the rolling window type as 4. Okay? 2 divided by span plus 1, which I had actually discussed in the Excel sheet. Right? This Excel sheet that just now we discussed, right? Right? If you want to calculate this. Right? Everybody clear? Guys, I know this is not that easy, but you have to learn it. Yes, it will be average only when you apply mean, right? So overall, how was the session, guys, till here? Now we will discuss the most amazing part. Which is the most, which moving average is the best? Okay, guys, which moving average is the best? Tell me. Obviously, exponential weighted moving average is the best, right? I know it is difficult. I know you'll scold me for that, Krish, what you're teaching. But truth is truth. Something is very good, right? You really need to know all these things. Okay, now what I'm actually going to do is that I'm going to talk about moving average model. Now, in ARIMA, let's say, in ARIMA, there are so many important concepts, right? The first thing is AR. The second thing is MA. And the initial thing, the middle thing over here, I'll talk about this also, okay? AR is nothing but autoregressive. Or I can say auto regression. This is nothing but moving average. If I combine this two, only this two, then it will basically become ARMA model. ARMA model is good for forecasting, right? Probably in sales, probably monthly productions, let's say. Something. But this will definitely not be helpful in stocks. Okay, don't do it. Waste of time. I'd suggest any model is waste for stocks. Okay, you cannot. If there is any specific model, everybody would have become a billionaire till now. Okay. So first of all, what we will do is that we will try to understand what exactly is moving average. Okay. So what exactly is moving average and how do you basically calculate the moving average? And which plots you specifically use with respect to moving average. Okay. One interview question, they'll say that for moving average, do you use PACF plot or ACF plot? Okay. This can be a question. Or they may say you that, okay, clearly tell me where is PACF used or where is ACF plot used? Whether PACF is used for moving average or whether ACF is used for autoregression. Okay. So this kind of questions may definitely come. Okay. And probably if you're working in one, any kind of financial data sets and all. Okay. So let's go ahead and let's first of all discuss about moving average models. What exactly is moving average models? Okay. Everybody, shall I start? Yes. Okay. So moving average models, what exactly it is? Let's say right now, what session we are doing in? I'm doing time series live sessions, right? What I'm actually doing? Time series live sessions. And obviously I want many people to join on my live sessions, but people don't understand the importance, so they'll not join. Or probably they may be busy in some or the other things, okay? Let's say that my expectation, if I probably say my expectation in with respect to the people attending the live session, let's say it is 1,000. Okay. Let's say that, or let not just take such a huge number. let's say my mean expectation, an average expectation of people visiting in everyday's live session is 10. Okay, just considering an example. So if I really want to calculate or create this moving average models, my formula will look something like this. Everybody focus over here. Okay. So I'll say my moving average is equal to mu plus my one coefficient. I'll write this coefficient as this symbol. And I'll say there will be an error term with respect to the previous timestamp. Okay. Previous timestamp, there'll be specifically one error. Now, this is basically my average, moving average formula. Here, you see this, my mean is nothing but 10. Okay. I'm saying that, okay, 10 people should come and join. That is what is my expectation. Let's say, here I'm just going to create a specific table. This is my timestamp with respect to day 1, day 2, day 3, day 4, day 5. Okay. And here I am just saying that this will be my moving average because I need to calculate by using this formula. Okay. Moving average, I need to calculate it. And let's say that my error term is obviously over here, which is specified by this. And finally, this entire calculation that I'm actually calculating, let's say that this is my real MA value. And this is my predicted MA value. Predicted MA value basically means what? I'm just going to calculate. And now in order to calculate my predicted MA value, I need to apply this specific formula. Okay. Very simple. Now, this is my real MA value, real moving average value. Okay. Real moving average value. Okay. Now, let's say that my error term over here is minus 2. It is probably 1 over here. It is again minus 1. It is 2. It is 0. Okay. Now, this basically means what? Okay. And let's consider that my initial coefficient that I'm assigned is 0.5. Okay. So this all, I have actually initialized this parameters and all. And always remember this values that you'll be seeing, this value, it will belong to a standard normal distribution where your mean will be specifically 0 and your standard deviation will be 1. Okay. So this error term that you are able to see, it belongs to a standard normal distribution where your mean is equal to 0 and standard deviation equal to 1. So you will be able to see this specific data mostly similar to this. Everybody clear till here? Everybody? Yes? Yes? Everybody clear till here? Yeah? Guys, clear till here? Just give me a quick yes. So that I further do the calculation with respect to moving average models. Right? Okay. Now tell me, suppose I was expecting 10 people to come, probably. I was expecting 10 people to come. But let's say the real value that came was somewhere around 8. If I'm getting 8 people who are attending day 1 live session, then what will be my this value? Think over it. It will be 8 plus 0.5. The error term will be minus 2, right? Because I was expecting 10. So 10 minus 8 is nothing but minus 2. Sorry, 8 minus 10 is nothing but minus 2. So here, if I calculate it, so here you'll be able to see that I'm actually getting how much? How much I'm getting? 8 plus? How much am I actually getting, guys? 8 minus 2, that is for this specific term. Okay, just a second. Okay, just a second. So my initial prediction was that I should be getting 10, but I got 8. And here the error term is minus 2. Okay. Now, in order to calculate the moving average, based on the moving average model for day 2, I will just say that, okay, fine. My moving average mean was basically 8. Okay. Just a second. Should be 10. 10 plus. 10 plus. What is this value? This value is nothing but 0.5. And this value is now error of this specific value. So it is minus 2. So 10 minus 1 will be what? 9. So am I getting 9 over here, everybody? Just see this. Am I getting 9 over here? Yes. Now, since I'm getting 9, okay, but I was expecting still 10 value. So if I probably do 10 minus 9, I'm actually getting the error value as 1, right? So here my real moving average should be 10, but I'm actually getting 1 over here as my error difference. Is everybody clear with respect to this? Yeah. Coefficient is just initialized. Don't worry. Right now, I'm just trying to calculate this. Now do this similar calculation for all the other things, guys. Okay. If my error is minus 1, what does this basically mean? If my error is minus 2, that basically means 8, right? See this. If my error is 1, what does this basically mean? This basically means my value that I am assuming, right? You will be able to see that over here it is 9, right? If my value is minus 1, what do you think by this? How much value will probably be I'll be getting in MA? Just tell me. MA prediction. Okay, just write it down, this specific table. I'll repeat it. I'll repeat it. Don't worry. I'll repeat it. Okay. Let's do one thing. Let's do this thing that I'm actually trying to do. Okay. Just a second. Don't worry. I will do it again. Okay, everybody's ready now. Again, I will try to do it for you. Okay. Okay, let me rub this again. Let me rub this. Okay. Okay, now let's calculate this values. Okay. Initially, you know that I'm expecting that I will be getting mean is equal to 10, right? Let me rub it again for you. Let's assume that my initial value that I want to calculate for MA hat basically means predicted one. Okay. Let's say my 10 value is there. Obviously, I'm expecting 10. Okay. I'm expecting 10. But over here, my error is minus 2. Okay. If it is minus 2, then what will happen? 0.5 multiplied by minus 2, right? Over here, if I see, this is my 10 initially. I want 10 over here. But since I got as minus 2 as my error, obviously my moving average will become 8 because 10 minus 2 will be 8, right? 10 minus 2 will be 8. Now, in order to calculate this row, MA hat, I will be using the previous MA values. And in order to use this, what I will do is 10 plus minus 0.5 minus multiplied by minus 2. So if I do this, this will basically get, I'll be getting as 9, right? So if I probably get 9 over here, but my error rate is 1. So if my error rate is 1, 9 plus 1 will basically be 10 over here, right? So this will basically be my moving average. It would have been 10, but because of this specific error, I'm getting this. Now, in order to calculate the third one, what I have to do? Again, do it for MA hat. For third row. So in order to calculate it for the third row, what I have to specifically do is that I will take this 9 value plus minus 0.5 multiplied by the previous error. The previous error is 1. So this will basically be 9.5. So if I'm actually getting 9.5 over here, 9.5 minus 1, how much it will become then? How much it will become? Tell me. 9.5 minus 1. Is it 9.5? Sorry, it is 10.5. My mistake. It is 10.5. So 10.5. So here I'm actually going to write it as 10.5 minus 1 will be nothing but 9.5, right? Based on the error. Okay, based on the error. Everybody focus on the error, and based on that, I'm actually trying to calculate, right? Now, similarly, if I want to calculate the fourth row of the moving average with the help of moving average model, then what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to basically take 10.5 plus 0.5 multiplied by minus 1. This was the previous error. So if I probably write 10.5 minus 0.5, which is going to become over here as 10. So 10 if I'm actually getting prediction. So it will be, the error term is basically 2. So 10 minus 2 will basically become, 10 plus 2 will basically become 12. Right? And similarly, if I try to calculate the last row, so here you'll be able to see the previous value was 10 plus 0.5 and multiplied by error as 2. So 10 plus 1 is equal to 11 and 11 plus 0 is equal to 11. So this is the expected and this is the predicted, right? And this is the error term, right? This is the error term. If we are getting minus, that basically means the expected was 9.5, but we got 10.5. Okay. I hope everybody is able to understand. And this is the same formula that gets applied with respect to finding the moving average. Calculation mistake where, guys? Just see this. Right? Initial error rate is mostly about initializing. See, I was expecting 10. Okay, I was expecting 10. But over there, what happened? People came as 8. See, I was expecting that 10 people will basically arrive in my live session. But only 8 people came. So I'm getting an error rate of minus 2. Right? Now, tomorrow's, if I want to calculate the moving average with the help of this moving average model, then what I will do? I will just apply this formula. So I have applied this formula for this. See, 10 plus 0.5 multiplied by minus 2. So this will be 10 minus 1. 10 minus 1 is nothing but 9. So tomorrow I'm expecting that at least 9 people will join. Now if I get an error rate of 1, this basically says that 10 people had actually come to see my live session. Okay. Then similarly, for the third place, what I'm actually doing, again, I want to see that how many people are going to come. So again, I'm going to calculate the moving average. Now it will be 9 plus 0.5 multiplied by 1. So here I'm actually getting 10.5. I'm predicting that, okay, 10.5 people will come. But how many people actually came because of this error rate? Only 9.5, right? 9.5 people had actually come over here. Now, when 9.5 actually people had come, obviously it is, sorry, this should be 10 minus 1. Okay, 10 minus 1, 9.5. 9.5 people had actually come. Then coming to this next one, I need to calculate this. So I'll be using 10.5 plus 0.5 minus 1. So here I'm actually getting 10. So if 10 is then, if the error rate is 2, that basically means I was expecting 10 people are actually going to come, but 12 people actually came. And similarly, I'm going to calculate this similarly, right? Okay. So one calculation was wrong, you said, right? 9.5. Okay, fine. My mistake. So here I have 9.5. So 9.5 minus 1, it is nothing but 8.5. This is 8.5. Now, is it clear? I think now the calculation is perfectly fine. Here I made one mistake. It could be 8.5. Yes, 8.5 is here, no? How to know value of ETA 1? What ETA 1? Okay. Yes. To calculate the next data point with respect to moving average, we are focusing on calculating this. Okay. With respect to this moving average models, we basically say. Right. But don't worry. Tomorrow, again, I'll repeat this because I really want to consider taking moving average, autoregressive, and that I value. This three, I will define it theoretically and probably give you a lot of problem statements to solve. Okay. Why this particular value is 0.5? This is just like a hyperparameter you can consider. And I'm actually going to consider this. Nimai Ghosh, go and take data science or go and call the support team. No. Go and call the support team. The number is given in the description. Go and check it out. Okay. Go and ask the team. They'll let you know everything. Every time that same person is asking the same question in the live session. Yes, Anurodh. You're absolutely right. Okay. So I hope everybody has understood this. It is a hyperparameter, guys, phi. Okay. So let me do one thing. Tomorrow, we will again repeat this moving average, autorema, and this I value. We'll try to find out in an amazing way what exactly it is and how we should basically go ahead with it. Okay. So today I'll just end the session because we have discussed many, many things today. And we are just in starting things. I thought that I'll try to cover this ACF, PACF, you know. But don't worry. Till here, we have covered completely. I've given you the introduction of moving average models. All right. So moving average models, again, tomorrow will be repeated. And we'll try to cover all these things. Okay. So great. These two sessions, I think it will get covered tomorrow. Okay. And tomorrow, I'll try to cover this in a better way. Okay. Yeah. Okay. And calculations wise, guys, when we are taking live session, we tend to make mistakes. Okay. So no need to act or, you know, it's okay. Okay. So, but I hope you have understood. Everybody understood moving average models? Everybody understood moving average models? This moving average models? Everybody understood moving average models? Yes. Moving average models. So here you are defining a model. You are defining a model. This model will able to do the forecasting in the future part. If we have the previous data. Suppose I have the T minus 1 data, T minus 2 data, T minus 3 data. By considering this, I can actually calculate the T data. Where I'm just focusing on the previous one. This is focused on this. This is focused on this. Like this. Right? Okay, perfect. Don't worry if you did not understand the last part. We'll again repeat it. Tomorrow, please make sure that you come to the session. Tomorrow is a very important session. Okay, everybody, please take out time and probably come. I know today is Saturday. Everybody likes to enjoy. But just come. It will be pretty much amazing. So thank you, everyone. And I will see you in tomorrow's session. Bye-bye. Have a great day. Thank you.